Roger and Diane Hunter, a Lakeland couple that got into beekeeping just a few years ago, were contacted to take apart this downtown building, saving as many bees, hives, and gallons of honey as possible.
You're talking about millions of trips. Millions of trips.
Someone asked for a beekeeper?
Although I'd surely be no help at all, they got me into an extra suit and sent me up into one of the hives they were taking down. And then we talked while Roger went to work. Is it safe to say that there might be tens or hundreds of hives similar to the ones that you've taken out of this building all across our city?
I would say so. My big rule is it's nature, so there are no rules. There could be one to, like in this building, we've got five hives.
There's no telling how many of the abandoned buildings across the Mid-South have massive hives like this one, but if they could be safely removed and relocated to a safe spot, it could present a boon for the bee shortage that has struck our country in recent years.
I've said I'll take bees from anywhere and any place, any type of building. So all I need is a lift and a way to get to it, and I'll take the bees.
How the heck did you get into this?
My daughter wanted a beehive. She's always loved bees since she was a little girl, and I ended up adopting her bees. Bees for me now are fantastic mental therapy. They're great for my nerves. They're great for my attitude.
Make no mistake, bees will get agitated if you mess with them, really something good. Roger took joy in scaring me with.
As I separate these right here.
Oh, don't do that. They're all over.
But whether you're a commercial owner with a big building to handle or a Mid-South native with a hive you don't want, there is a peaceful way to deal with these insects.
Google Memphis Area Beekeepers Association, and then there is a bee removal list on there.